Hello students, it's me, Miss Mariana again, and I'm going to work with you today, okay? Today we're going to study simple present interrogative form, okay? We have just been studying affirmative and negative, so today we have to finish with interrogative way. So pay attention to the next. Simple present interrogative. Now you are going to listen to four famous songs about interrogative form. Here we go. Number one, pay attention.
Well, I fall asleep, spilling drinks on my settee. Do I wanna know if this feeling flows both ways? Sorta hoping that you stay.
Okay, that was number one. Let's continue with number two. Here we go.
What do you mean tonight?
Okay, number three.
Elsa? Do you want to build a snowman?
Okay, and number four. This is another famous song. Okay, you already listened four famous songs. What do they have in common? What do they share? Very good. All these four songs share questions. Which were the questions? Did you get that? ¿Alcanzaste a escuchar las preguntas? No? Don't worry. Let's check. In number one, Arctic Monkeys song, the question was, do I want to know? Number two, Dua Lipa's song was, do we need somebody just to feel like we are all right? Number three, Frozen's song was the question, do you want to build a snowman? And the last one, One Direction's song, the question was, does he know you can move it like that? Okay, so as you can notice, these four songs showed us different questions. And that's why I wrote it in different colors to explain you the following. The structure. The structure interrogative form in simple present, you can follow the next order. First, the auxiliary verb do or does. After that, we include the subject, okay? Then we include the present verb or action, and finally the predicate, which sometimes is optional. This complement is optional, not always necessary to include it. Okay, examples. Do we study English on Thursday? As you can see, here we have the auxiliary verb do, then we have the subject we, then the action study, and finally the predicate or complement. English on Thursdays. The last example. Does the human body contain 500 bones? One more time, we have the auxiliary verb does. Then the subject, the human body. Later we have the verb contain. And finally, 500 bones, which is the predicate or complement. Remember that in English, we include the interrogative question mark at the end. Solamente al final va el signo de interrogación, chicos. No al comienzo como en español. Okay? Next. Remember. Recuerden, esto es súper importante. We have different types of subjects. I know you already watched this before, but it's necessary you remember every time. Personal pronouns is one type of subjects. Which are the personal pronouns? I, you, we, they, he, she, and it. common nouns can be another type of subject, which are the examples mother, brother, dog, rabbit, book, radio, etc. And proper nouns, for example, Chile, Sandra, Mariana, Concepcion, etc. Okay? The same difference. Okay, in the first video of simple present affirmative, we mentioned that the main difference is that we include an S, incluimos una S, at the end of the action, at the end of the verb, when we talk about he, she, and it. Yes? In the negative form, Miss Sandra explained that there is also another difference in terms of auxiliary verb. We have two auxiliary verbs for negative, don't and doesn't. Doesn't is for he, she, and it, and don't is for I, you, we, they, and you. In interrogative form, we also have a difference, which is the following. We are going to divide into two groups. The first group, as in the first two videos, the first group is I, you, we, they, you. These five people, or these five pronouns, they are going to use the following auxiliary verb, do. Okay, when you want to make a question in simple present with one of these, any of these people, you have to use this auxiliary verb, do. Do I, do you, do we, do they, or do you? On the other hand, we have he, she, and it. In this case, we do not use do. We use does. So that is, does he, does she, does it, okay? For example, do you have English classes? Does she have English classes? Etc. Now, a little help. When you use the question in the previous people, means this group, he, she, or it, the action or verb is without S because it's hidden in does. This means, in affirmative form, we have to include the S at the end of the action, al final del verbo. In the case of the question, you cannot include the S. No puedes incluir la S because it's hidden, está escondida here, in the does auxiliary verb, okay? So now, I want you please go to your book and open it on page number 12. Okay, so here we go. Page number 12, activity number 3. Read the dialogue again. Study the highlighted forms. Complete the examples in the Learn This box. Okay, the dialogue was above. Yes, was previous. So, but by now we will not work it. So, present simple, negative, and interrogative. We form the present simple negative with don't or doesn't and the infinitive of the verb without to. So you have to complete here. With the negative form, don't or doesn't, I play football. So what you are going to write, I don't play football or I doesn't play football. And here number two, the same. She play football. She don't play football or she doesn't play football. Letter B. We form the present simple interrogative with do or does and the infinitive of the verb without to. We form short answers with do. Do, does, don't, and doesn't. You have to here complete the questions and the short answers. You play football. So, how is the question? Do you play football or does you play football? Yes, I do. No, I don't. Or no, I doesn't. Does he play football? Yes, he does. No, he doesn't. Okay, so complete this question. And once you finish, you continue with the next. Next activity. So next activity is activity number 4. In your copybook, You have to answer this en tu cuaderno. Make these sentences negative. Number one, for example, my aunt works in London. Here you have a clue, la pista, works, my aunt. So the negative is my aunt doesn't work in London. Doesn't work. You can see here the action is without the S because it's here. Number two, I like rap music. Three, my cousins Emma and Zoe speak Spanish. My stepbrother Nick plays in a volleyball team. Joe and I walk to school. You study Chinese. Remember, you have to transform into negative sentences, okay? So you have to do this in your copybook. Next activity, number five. Write the words in the correct order to make questions. You need to add do or does. Leave you the school near? Okay, so here first you need to identify the subject, the action, and the rest of the sentence or predicate here, okay? So you have to order the question, but remember, recuerda, to include do or does at the beginning of the question, al comienzo, okay? You have to do these five questions in your copybook too, okay, en tu cuaderno. Next activity, the last one. Write true sentences, activity number seven. Write true sentences about yourself, real questions, real sentences. Use the present simple affirmative or negative and the phrases below. For example, one, get up early on Saturdays. A real sentence is, I don't get up early on Saturdays, okay? What about number two? Play ice hockey. I play ice hockey. Or I don't play ice hockey, okay? About you, okay? Real sentences, okay? So remember, all these activities are going to be checked on our online session next Tuesday. Septimo A with me and Septimo B with Miss Sandra. So you need to be ready with your activities for our mid session, okay? So take care and see you next time. Bye-bye.